with us tirelessly. She's been working with the medical community. She's been on her legislators. She's done everything she knows to do as a citizen lobbyist, and she's done a hell of a job. Grace Henderson, I've asked her to come and speak to you for a couple of things. Grace, come up and say a few words.
Side effects. Maybe the people that won't hear this bill don't want that to happen. I don't care what they want. This is what I want. Yeah. For me, this battle is about patient rights. I have tried every pharmaceutical that's been suggested. I want the opportunity to legally try what has been shown to work in medicinal cannabis states. 34 states, yes. 4 out of 5 territories, and the District of Columbia. 66% of the population of America now has access to medical cannabis. Why can't we have that? Why don't we deserve this opportunity because we love where we live? Is regulated by naturally produced chemicals called endocannabinoids. These molecules balance biological functions such as sleep, appetite, the immune system, pain, and more. When the body gets out of balance and moves into a state of stress, endocannabinoids go to work to fix the problem. The medicinally active components in the cannabis plant mimic endocannabinoids and so can be effective in helping the body manage crises and restore itself after trauma. Our bodies are made for this medicine. Political reasons are not good enough to deny us this. Kentucky patients deserve access to every single medicine that can help to improve our quality of life, and we have a right to choose our own medicine. If this medicine can help even one person function better, then we deserve it. I think we all ought to be able to have whatever helps us manage our symptoms because we're not hurting anyone else. And I'm advocating for people to be able to go to work and come home and medicate in a way that works for them. House Bill 136 is about legitimately achieving symptom relief for patients without risking going to jail for it. It's about parents being able to give their suffering children herbal medicine without fear of losing custody or having their assets seized. It's about the parents of Kenzie Myers having the right to decide to treat their daughter's ulcerative colitis with something safer than the toxic combination of mercaptopurine and Remicade that killed her colon when she was 12. It's about Alexandria Fulkerson having the right to decide to treat her daughter Colby's seizures with something safer than the Versed that keeps that toddler in a bed. It's about Kristen Wilcox having the right to decide to treat her daughter Shelby's Dravet syndrome with something that doesn't leave her dignity on the floor of Walmart for all of her to gawk at. It's about veterans having the right to decide to treat their PTSD with something safer than the pills the VA throws.
Yeah! Yeah!
Why do our legislators themselves in our health care. I came to this rally 2 years ago, and Ashley Taylor said something that really hit home to me. She looked around the room and said, "There's no quit in this room." I remember crying that day. She inspired me, and I hope that I can inspire others to do the same. We do not quit. We do not become passive aggressive on this issue. We do not surrender. We win this fight, and we do it together. United we stand, and divided we fall. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.